Okay, let's keep going. And the last one is excretion. Excretion is you send the molecule from lumen into bladder. So first, the plasma being filtered in, we call the lumen. In the beginning part, the lumen is very similar to your blood, to your plasma. And they start being processed. Most of them been reabsorbed back. Some molecules like hydrogens or some toxic molecules will be reabsorbed back, will be secreted in. And eventually when you handle to here, this liquid is very similar to your urine. And once it goes to your bladder, we call the urine. It's not blood anymore. So your urine directly comes from your blood. And excretion is this part. You send them out. So how much you excrete it depends on how much been filtered in. If you filter in nothing, you get nothing, like red blood cell. Excretion rate of red blood cell is supposed to be zero because no red blood cell can be filtered in. If they can be filtered in, you have to subtract out how much being re-taken back, reabsorption, like glucose. Even though glucose will be filtered in, but the reabsorption rate is 100%. So you filter in 20 glucose, you take in 20 glucose, and you still got zero excretion. And excretion equals to the filtration, subtract out reabsorption, plus secretion, like penicillin, okay? You filtered in 20 penicillin, you end up get 40 penicillin because you secrete 20 more. So it's this equation, how much you filtered in, subtract out how much you've been taken back, and plus how much you secrete in, equal to the excretion rate, how much you get here. So the excretion depends on the movement of the molecules out of your body, and it becomes the urine. So it depends on the urine flow, multiply the urine concentration. And depends on the how much your body handled and handle, we say the net secretion or net reabsorption. And now let's look at the concept called clearance. Clearance is how much blood plasma being cleaned per time. That's called clearance. So the equation is urine flow multiplied urine concentration divided by the plasma concentration. And to do this calculation, we have to assume 100% of plasma will be filtered back, or will be reabsorbed back. It's not too far from the truth, actually, because over 99% of them will be taken back. So this time we just assume 100% of them will be taken back. And clearance, we use it to estimate GFR, estimate how a molecule being handled by the nephron. Okay, let's look at clearance. So clearance, you really need to think about the kidney is like the filter. It filters your blood. So when the blood being sent here, you have in urine, this is the molecules. They will be filtered in. So you have the dirty blood. You have four dirty particles in urine. They've been filtered in. And how much blood's been cleaned, that's clearance. So these four molecules being sent here, 100 mL of water being sent here. And all 100 mL, we assume 100% reabsorption. So all the plasma will be taken back. But those in urine, your body don't take them back, don't secrete them. So how much you send in, that's four, will be excreted out. So eventually, after you run through this machine, this filter, you found, okay, all 100 mL of plasma being cleaned, and we say the clearance rate is how much you send in. So in urine's clearance is 100 ml per minute, because every minute you send 100 ml of dirty water in, and they're all being cleaned. So the clearance equal to GFR when you do the calculation, equal to the excretion rate divided by the plasma concentration. And for the molecule, if it's handled neither reabsorbed nor secreted, you found the clearance equal to the GFR. And when we do the renal calculation, we want to use this molecule. In urine, that's the molecules. We want to use this molecule because this molecule helps us to figure out what's the GFR. And now let's look at glucose. Glucose, we know glucose is 100% reabsorbed back. So let's see what happens. So you have 100 mL of plasma being dumped in. You have 4 glucose inside. They've been processed. Okay, now you take 100 ml of plasma back because we assume 100% reabsorption. And all the 4 glucose will be taken back as well because glucose is 100% reabsorbed. And when we look at the blood after this machine, we found, okay, we have 100 ml of plasma. We also have 4 glucose. It's as dirty as before. So we say this machine does not clean this plasma at all of glucose. So when we do the calculation, because you have nothing in the urine, so clearance equal to the excretion rate divided by the plasma concentration. Excretion rate is 0 because no glucose come out. So clearance is 0, 100% reabsorbed. So when we see a molecule, its clearance is 0, means all this molecule 100% reabsorbed like glucose. Now let's look at urea. Urea is the molecule. You have 100 mL and you send them in. You have 4 urea. So that's the dirty blood, dirty water. Let's see what happened. Urea is a 50% reabsorbed. So what happens, go to here. Plasma, 100% taken back, 100 mL. And those urea, 1, 2, 3, 4. You take 50% back, you take 2 back, 2 being excreted. And when we look at the plasma being processed after this machine, we found we have 100 ml of plasma plus 2 urea compared with 4. And we say, well, okay, it's 50% being cleaned. And when we calculate the clearance rate, excretion is you have 2 being excreted divided by the plasma concentration. Of course, it's smaller than GFR because you dump in 4. So we found the clearance is smaller than the GFR. We know this molecule is handled as net reabsorption. It's like 50% being cleaned, 50% still dirty. So the clearance is smaller than the GFR, which represents the net reabsorption. And let's look at the last one, penicillin. Penicillin is the molecule you have secretion. So let's see what happened. You dump in the 100 ml of blood with 4 penicillin. And when you go to here, you dump in 2 more. You dump in 2 more. So those 100 ml of blood being cleaned and plus 2 more, you have 50 ml being cleaned as well in the secretion part. So you secrete more, you secrete 6 penicillin molecule, even though you only filtered in 4. And when we do the calculation, we found the excretion rate divided by the plasma concentration. This number is actually bigger than the GFR. GFR is you filtered in only 4 and you excrete 6. So when we found the clearance is bigger than GFR, which represent is net secretion, like penicillin. So after we finish the clearance, the maturation is pretty straightforward. It's a parasympathetic reflex. So this explains before potty trained. Before potty trained, the maturation is a reflex. After potty trained is you learn to use your skeletal muscle. There's the muscle outside help to block this sphincter. But for the baby before potty trained, that's what happened. It's parasympathetic. So the first is when your bladder is full of urine, you have the sensory neuron send the information into your spinal cord. And spinal cord will go out two output. One is release the sphincter. So it will ask the motor neuron stop firing. So stop contract this sphincter so it relax. And also it will ask the smooth muscle of the bladder to contract, and both of them, the end result is urine come out. So it happened in a baby when the bladder is full, they will do the maturation. Okay, that's it.